We're going to be solving partial differential equations. Partial differential equations have partial derivatives. So in this video, let me briefly explain to you the difference between a regular derivative and a partial derivative. We're considering a function now, which is a function of two variables, x and y. So we need to think about what does it mean to differentiate f with respect to x, and what does it mean to differentiate f with respect to y. So we have to write down a definition. So we define the partial derivative of f with respect to x. The symbol we use is this curly d, and we call this partial f with respect to x. Remember your definition of the derivative. Here we have a similar definition, the limit as delta x goes to 0 of f of x plus delta x y minus f of x y divided by delta x. And that defines the partial derivative of f with respect to x. In a similar way, you can define the partial derivative of f with respect to y, and you can define higher order partial derivatives. What's the meaning of this expression? It means you take the derivative of f with respect to x, keeping y fixed. So basically, in this expression, you consider y as if it is a constant, right, a number, and you differentiate the expression only with respect to x. It's easy to look at an example. So let's look at a simple example. So f of x, y, let's say this is 2x cubed y squared plus y cubed, so a function of x and y. So let's calculate the partial derivatives. The partial derivative of f with respect to x means we differentiate this expression, taking the derivative with respect to x, treating y as a constant. So we have the derivative of x cubed is 3 times x squared times 2 here, so 6x squared y squared. And the derivative of y cubed with respect to x would be 0. So y just looks like a constant. Okay. The other derivative, df with respect to y, partial of f with respect to y is the right way of saying it. You differentiate the y squared, you get 2y, so that would become 4x cubed y, and you differentiate the y cubed, that would become 3y squared, so plus 3y squared. Okay, how about second derivatives? The second derivative of f with respect to x, we say partial squared f with respect to x squared, partial squared f over partial x squared, partial squared f with respect to x, different ways of saying it. This one, you just keep differentiating. So this should be 12 times xy squared. And partial squared f with respect to y would be 4x cubed, differentiating y, plus 6y. There's one more second derivative. That's the mixed partial. So we have d squared f with respect to x and y. Okay, that's called the mixed partial derivative. We differentiate partial of f with respect to x with respect to y. That will give us 12x squared y. But we could also differentiate partial of f with respect to y with respect to x. the 3y squared would be 0 if you differentiate with respect to x, and then we would get 12x squared y, the same. So this is equal to partial squared f with respect to y with respect to x, the mixed partial. Here you do the y derivative first, then the x derivative. Here you do the x derivative first, then the y derivative, or vice versa. But it doesn't really matter, because you're always going to get the same answer. OK, so this is straightforward differentiation. Another important feature here is called the chain rule, which is a very useful rule for derivatives. Everybody knows the chain rule when you have a function of one variable. But we can look at a function f of t of, say, one variable, but that's actually a function of two variables. It's just that each variable depends on t. Okay? So you can view f as a function of t, or you can view f as a function of x and y. So you can ask the question, what is the derivative of f with respect to t? And you can use partial derivatives to figure that out. You can do a very, very simple derivation. But in the end, you just remember the formula. It's straightforward. It's the partial of f with respect to x. And then it's the derivative of x with respect to time, plus the partial of f with respect to y, and the derivative of y with respect to time. OK, that's the chain rule for partial derivatives. You can generalize this to more complicated cases. It's useful in very specific sorts of problems. It's rather straightforward and easy to remember. Let me review. We're going to be doing partial differential equations in this differential equations class. And so you need to know what a partial derivative is. It's rather a straightforward generalization of a normal derivative. You have a function of, say here, two variables, and you want to differentiate with just respect to one of the variables. You treat the second variable as a constant, and then you can differentiate. You have two first-order derivatives, and then you have three second-order derivatives. The complication here is you have a mixed partials, but it doesn't matter what order you differentiate in. You can do x first, then y, or you can do y first and then x. Another thing you sometimes need is the chain rule for functions of more than one variable. Here, for this particular example, I have a function of x and y, but x and y themselves are functions of t. Sometimes x and y are position, and t is the time. We want to find the time derivative of f. We can use the chain rule, partial f with respect to x, dx dt, plus partial f with respect to y, dy dt. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching.